The Smarter CA webinar. Today we have with us some of our esteemed clients, Mr. Kripsan Manandar, Mr. Narayan Prajapati, and Mr. Deepam Patel, who will be talking you through their journey with iFirm and overall practice management. I will be sharing a brief presentation now with you. Please let me know once it's visible.
Can see it, Chris.
Great. So first of all, I hope everyone is safe, and you know, given these trying times, I hope everyone is taking care. We at Wolters Kluwer are extremely customer and employee centric, and we are trying to do our best to support our clients and our employees and all our stakeholders during these tough times. And this is why we thought this theme is very apt for discussion today, because technology and remote work is really the mantra for coming through this, you know, trying time that we are all facing globally. I would just like to kick off and say that, you know, Wolters Kluwer and CCH are names you may or may not be that familiar with. We are a couple of hundred year old company, been in tax and accounting, serving this sector for over 100 years. We've been in India for over a decade. And globally, we are a large listed company with revenue of about $5 billion. Our focus is to help bring our global tried and tested solutions customized to India, and that's what we'll talk about. For us, you know, why are we talking about digital? And, you know, as a company, we ourselves have transformed over the last 200 years, and that's what we are seeing for the entire sector, particularly for tax and accounting, how transformation and digital is really making things change for all of us and touching our lives. So all forward-thinking organizations are leveraging digital technologies, right? Everybody's using automation, cloud, mobile, analytics. Now we see new IPOs of even company startups like Zomato, MobiQuick coming with billions of dollars of valuation, right? So all of this value is being created by people who are adopting technology, leveraging this digital wave that we are really witnessing. And what does all of this do? It helps us improve our efficiencies. It helps generate maybe new revenue streams and create new customer experiences and rapidly respond to this changing conditions. And the CA profession is something which is also changing dramatically. And over the last, you know, 4 or 5 years that we've been in this business of process automation for CAs, we've seen a huge change in the way our customers are receptive to the products, in the way they're using the products, and they're really extracting the maximum value out of those. So never before, you know, setting your strategy has been so important by using technology. Our recent surveys of over 500 people have shown that people who are able to adopt, you know, these technologies initially are the ones who reap the maximum benefits in their revenue and profits. And I think that's where we really see, you know, India is still at a stage where we are still in the early adopter stage. We have not yet become mainstream in terms of technology for the CA profession in many aspects. So I think that's where really the big opportunity for you lies. If you're able to digitize your firm, you're able to differentiate yourself in the market. There are lots of areas where you can use technology. Some of you may already be using, for example, for accounting, definitely for maybe payroll, maybe for tax filing, your TDS, GST, etc. Some may be also using for billing, but there are a lot of other work streams, you know, your time tracking, workflow. How do you manage the project? How do you manage customer relations? How do you document things? Where do you store all of this? Is it all paper? If it's digital, is it all stored in the right way? How do you manage expenses? There are multiple ways in which technology can touch your lives and create a harmonious solution. Now, lot of this workflow is depending on priorities, right? Clients give a lot of information to managers, to partners, et cetera, and then this is disseminated down to your staff. And then the partner does not have a bird's eye view of what's really happening, where's the workflow, what project is on track, what is behind, how much are we billing, etc. And a lot of information is coming in various tools. It can be Excel spreadsheets, could be PDFs, could be Word docs, PPTs, so on and so forth. Is there really something that is harmonious, right? How does a firm get a full view of where they are and where they're headed? How do they plan for the next year? That is something which technology can really, really help you with. And how do you allocate work, right? Typically, workflow comes in all of these things that we talked about, physical documents, and then this has an impact on productivity because half the time we are just chasing the documents. Where did the document? Is that the latest version? Who stored it? That person is on leave today. Oh, that person's laptop is not working, something or the other. So one area we have contact database, one area is job management, one area is different templates, invoicing. All of this stuff is all separated. What we are proposing is something which is not disconnected, something which is connected, something where jobs can be allocated, you have an integrated view, you're able to do capacity planning, you can understand how much are you really charging per job, how your data is aging, where's the invoicing happening. All of these things can happen through a practice management solution, and our customers will talk more about that. And it gives you, as owners, managers of the firm, a very strong view already in reports which are already generated. Your team doesn't need to sit and generate them. Ready information for you to be able to make decisions. Because I think everybody is now overloaded with information. They want solutions. They want to be able to make decisions quickly. And that's where we come in. So if you look at it, our tool will cover all of these activities that you're doing within your firm, unify them, and create a single seamless platform. We are the most awarded practice management tool. Globally, we are present with over 10,000 CA firms in North America, in Asia Pacific, in India, and Southeast Asia. We have lots of additional modules like client portal, document management, practice manager, so on and so forth, which can help you pick and choose what would be the right platform for you, and then be able to complete your entire firm's activity through our software. Thank you. Now I would be handing over to Mr. Cripson, who will walk you through his journey. Thank you all so much. We will be open for questions as well.
Thank you, Mr. Chris.
Over to you, Mr. Cripson. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, everyone. So I'll begin with sharing my slides now. So is my slide visible?
Yes.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, so once again, good afternoon, everyone. I hope all of us and our family are safe in this COVID situation. First of all, I would like to thank Mr. Prasoon Nevar and the entire Wolters Kluwer family for this opportunity to speak and share our firm's experience of digital transformation. So I would like to start with my brief introduction. I'm a partner at Sankar Associates Chartered Accountant and a director at Fort Symmetron's Business Consulting Private Limited. I have been in the audit and assurance service for more than 10 years and currently lead the SME division in my firm. So briefly speaking about my firm, Sankar Associates Chartered Accountant is an audit and assurance firm located in Kathmandu, Nepal. We started with four friends as member of senior management team and two staffs in 2016. And now, we have grown into a mid-sized firm with overall staff strength of 50, including four members. We are also a member of MGI Worldwide since 2019, which is a top 20 network of independent accounting firms. So with that, let's get into the details. So right from the start of our firm, we had the shared vision to outgrow from the traditional process and methods of service delivery management. We wanted to see our firm as a seamless digital workplace. Our motto right from the start was quality service and value addition to our clients. And we always thrive for growth through excellence with this motto in mind. And we knew that digitization was the only way forward if we were to outgrow the market and achieve our strategic vision. So we envisioned a digital roadmap to achieve our strategic objectives. The digital roadmap included key steps starting from need assessment, adopting the right choice, and to continuous learning. Only after successful completion of all these stages, we would see ourselves as a digitally enabled firm. And we believe this will ultimately pave our way for future success. So let's go into the details again. First, the need assessment. We had reached a size where keeping track of individual staff work, allocations, their assigned jobs and timesheets, sharing documents, their leave scenario, directions and supervision of team members from senior management team was almost impossible manually. We had problems managing our billings and keeping track of receivables. This is when we decided that we should go for digitization. For that, we developed a roadmap of gradually digitizing our individual processes. Though we had set a roadmap, we had not formally started to work on it. We were in a preliminary stage prior to the COVID-19 breakouts. And after that, it hit us very hard and we couldn't continue our work. Thus, the COVID, in a way, triggered us and helped us accelerate the implementation. We had to manage such large team remotely, and it felt impossible to do without a reliable tool. We felt it was the right moment for us to go and for it and began actively looking for solutions. Thus, the situation of COVID-19 gave us the time to think one step forward and try all the best possible way to turn the roadmap into action. Now, once we decided to go for the digitization, for adopting the right choice, we had to consider many parameters, but we summed up our requirements into whether we wanted to develop a software of our own or buy a readily available software. To make this decision, we set few parameters to address, the first being the money factor. We analyzed the cost component. We looked into the initial development cost versus the purchase cost, the subsequent maintenance and AMC costs, and also the infrastructure costs associated with it. The second is the user friendliness. We looked into the ease of use by the partners as well as the staffs, the ease to view the dashboard reporting, requirement of our MIS reports. The other one being the agility, whether it was easy to implement and capable to provide support to senior management for client relationship management, project management, staff management, talent and resources management, billings and receivables, and whether this all could be bundled into one whole package. And finally, the maintenance support. We looked into the maintenance cost for the software as well as the after sales support. So with all these parameters in mind, we decided that using the readily available software would be the ideal start for us. So for this, we looked into our network and if any of our network firms were already implementing such software. And in our case, luckily, we got chance to consult with our friend, Mr. Anuj Sirdalal from our network member firm, CR Sirdalal & Company, which is based in Ahmedabad, India, who was already using CCH iPhone. This proved to be a huge booster for us as we analyzed other various software before ultimately deciding to go for the iPhone. Now, once we decided to go for it, the entire process is a continuous learning process. We had to learn, unlearn, and relearn throughout our entire implementation cycle. We also faced with some challenges which we successfully turned into opportunities. Some of the challenges we faced were resistance to change by our staffs, limited staff capabilities, also backlash from clients in the initial stage, and implementation of international standards into our local context. The staffs had to go out of their comfort zone, and to onboard them in this journey was the most crucial part. To address this, we adopted a flexible organizational structure and gave our full support for implementation. We shared our visions and values with our staffs at core and included them in the decision-making process as well. We conducted multiple rounds of orientations and trainings of our staffs until they were confident enough. And also we tried to localize the resources available in the application format. In overall, we put our dedication and trust in the adopted software application and encouraged staffs to come up with their suggestions as well. So the result now is that the opportunities we have now in delivery of quality service, efficient process management, and capable workflows. So to sum up, our implementation process till now was gradual and full of challenges. We were patient in our approach and had faith that it would materialize. Now I can proudly say that we have implemented the software successfully and are reaping the benefits. And now we are one step closer in our journey of digitization. So with this, I would like to conclude my few words and thank the AlterClues family again for the opportunity and would like to hand the floor over to Narayan. Thank you.
So thank you, Krishan, for sharing the insights. So I would like to carry on from now. So can you all view my slides, right?
Yes, we can.
So beginning with my short introduction, I am Narayan Prajapati, partner at Shankar Estate Chartered Accountants and Director at Foshimentum's Business Consulting Private Limited. And I have been in the audit and assurance services for more than 9 years now. And also recently I have been leading the outsourcing business division within the consulting firm under the consulting wing. And firstly, I would also like...
Yeah, sorry.
Firstly, I would like to thank Ulrich Kluwer family for this opportunity to showcase our experience to such an aspiring group of audiences. So I think every CA firm can relate what Cripson has already shared regarding the challenges and the opportunities. And I would like to focus on the opportunities that turn into benefits for our firm from the use of the software. So basically, I have categorize the benefits into three core areas from the perspective of people, process, and product, and I will discuss in detail in the following slides also. So beginning with the people, the benefits that we receive from the software, I have categorized further into three main categories from the perspective of partner, from the perspective of staffs, and from the perspective of clients. So beginning with the partners, so time tracking and management has been very easy with the use of the software. Now we can log in our time and also track our time spending on each resources easily via the software. Also regarding the resource planning, we could also plan the staffs accordingly for the each assignment, and so that no project is understaffed or overstaffed. And also the software has also saved us our hours from the routine admin works also, and that has been a huge boost in saving the opportunity cost for the senior management team. This has also then provided the flexibility to think and apply the strategic decisions for our firm also. And moving on to the staffs, the same goes with the time tracking. The attendance process has been much simpler, and the payroll processing has been also easier. And also we could track the efficiency of our staffs. We could log in the budgeted hours allocated for each project, and the staffs could also log in the actual hours they have spent for each project, so that we could also track the efficiency of the staffs. And regarding the accountability and responsibility, we could also view the involved in a particular and the stage where particular staff was involved. So we could also fix the accountability and responsibility on part of staffs also. And also the software has allowed us to have an easy involved also, where we could share the resources and regarding the clients, the CRM management has been very much easier with the practice management software. Like we had managed data all at a single place, and also we could view the key contacts for each clients or a group of clients, and also we could view the processes from the leads conversion to prospects and to clients also. And as said earlier, it was very easy to communicate with clients also by email, newsletter, and through the shared platform. Overall, the software has allowed us to collaborate together for a virtual workspace with a minimal physical presence. Now, moving on to the benefits regarding the process optimization. So, beginning with the process optimization, like we were able to automate certain manual processes, like tracking the reimbursable cost of staffs and putting up automatic reminder emails where we didn't have to memorize manually to send a reminder for clients. And also the tracking number for staffs, which our accountant took almost a day, now could be done with. And another benefit was regarding the dashboard reporting, where we could have the handy MIS reports at a glance, and also we could have a visual trail of all the processes at the single window. And moving on to engagement management, so we could see the progress of the each engagement. We could identify the hurdles that were we faced in the each engagement, and also we could check the budget overruns in case of engagements. And then further moving on for the process benefits, like already I have said, it provided us with the shared knowledge information platform and knowledge portal, notice boards and newsletter. We could easily and securely share all the information that we had with us within the form also. And also the software already had prepared available resources which we could localize with minimal efforts and share seamlessly with our staffs and client also. And another process benefit that we achieved was the standardization and uniformity in the processes that we achieved through standard work checklists and templates, so that the quality of the workflow was maintained throughout the firm. And lastly, the billing process management. So we had a clear picture from invoicing to receivables to realization at each stages of billing, and also lost billings was almost minimized to greater extent. And also we could track the pending receivables, and also help the portal also help in easy collection of the pending receivables also. So further moving on to the benefits regarding the products of the service delivery. So through the use of the software, clear vision of the service delivery capabilities of the firm, like the types of services we can deliver to our clients, and also we could determine the profitability of each service or client or group of clients. And from that, we could also identify unique selling points for our firm. So we could handpick the most efficient, economic, and effective services that we could deliver to our clients. And from all these, we had a focused marketing decisions. Now, with the right information at the right time, we could identify the target clients, our target services, and allocate our marketing budget accordingly. So in a nutshell, the digital journey has been very exciting, and we are looking for a promising future ahead with the digitization. And so we are planning for more digitization and more automation of the workflow or work process that we have in place. So we are further planning for automation of the financial reporting templates, audit planning documents, and audit working papers, and audit reports and management letters. And apart from that, the software has also provided us time to think of new strategic service avenues besides regular audit and assurance, like business outsourcing and offshoring. Like we've been able to collaborate with international business firms through our local DEX, like we have been providing bookkeeping services to US-based firm, and also in New Zealand and UK. And also we have been providing data enrichment services and IT allied services to clients based in Netherlands. So I think the software has provided us with a huge boost to our achievement of the strategic vision we have, and also has benefited us a lot than the investment that we made in the software. So that's all from our part. I would like to thank you all for being such a gracious audience, and for the patients, our personal as well as experience. We would love to hear the response and feedback from you all. Thank you. So I would like to pass on to Mr. Dipam Patel for further presentation.
Thank you, Narayanji. It was very insightful to learn about your journey. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. And I thank Wolters Kluwer for giving us the opportunity to present how we have been leveraging technology in growing our practice, or maybe in managing our practice. Ideally, today's discussion focus, we'll be concentrating on specific benefits that we have got through iFirm. What I've tried to do in today's webinar, I have tried to segregate the contents into, first of all, as you all have joined in here today, it's possibly that you are exploring iFirm as an option to implement in your firm. So that's why I'll try to be in a position where I can help you see if the features that are available in iFirm can benefit your firm, can benefit your practice. What I've done is I've first of all tried to identify what iFirm is for your firm. Second, I've segregated a certain set of case studies where we have seen how we have used iFirm to get where we are and maybe even improving day by day. And obviously, what were the things that our firm explored while we chose iFirm? I think we are now with iFirm since 4 or 5 years, and I don't have much issues with it. So it's a great product, and I'll give you my experience overall, and you will come to know why it's a product that will help you in your practice. And we'll do a cost benefit analysis also. So first of all, what is iFirm? Walters Kluwer, definitely they say that it's a practice management software ecosystem. It's a cloud-based software, and it helps in integrating, monitoring, and streamlining all the key facets of your profession. Well, that it does it very well. My take to it is that iFirm is what an ERP is to your client. So if you are a chartered accountancy firm, you know how your client's business grows because they use an ERP and how essential an ERP is for their business. So when we look at iFirm, our idea is that it's our ERP. You know, you have the same issues that a client has with an ERP. You know, you have a client which is running Tally. Now they don't integrate inventory into it. Then you know that the benefits of using a ERP system, they have a limitation. Same is with SAP. If you have an MM module and you can't use it to the full potential, or even you don't use the HR, then that has a limitation. You know, it's the same user level acceptance limitation which applies to any software. I see iFirm as the ERP of a chartered accountancy firm, and that's how simply I can describe iFirm and the benefits that it can bring to you. We'll focus on a few case studies. We'll focus on how we use it to drive quality within our firm. You know, I think certification as a chartered accountant is a job that comes across with all chartered accountants in practice. Certification for tender, certification for FEMA purposes, for Companies Act, whatsoever. So how did we standardize certification into our process? So we added checklists to the job. What we have done is that whenever there is a certification requirement coming in from a client, a job for that certification is punched in. It has various benefits. You can track it. You can see how much time and resources are going into that job. When is it due? What is the status? All that. In addition to that, it has a very good feature called checklists. You can customize this checklist. This is a checklist that we have prepared for our firm. First of all, it has to be a letter or an email that requests the certificate. So that standardizes the request process. We have kept a sign-off and a review for those. You can customize sign-off and review also. So first of all, you have checklist items. We have a process where we have getting signed documents, draft certificate with the partner. Then you share it with the client because you have always changed the format from what the tender requires or the template that the client gives, because you have to comply with the guidance notes. So you do all that, and then you have a generate UDIN. We also put a UDIN over here. Second thing is that you can assign the users for each of the jobs. Generally for a certification job, you won't require it much because you'll assign it to a single user. But for larger works like say an assurance engagement where it's a long process and there are multiple team members, you can segregate the parts of the financial statement or your steps in the process of audit, and you can assign that to the individual user. That helps you in tracking who is responsible for this long after it is done. It's very useful for peer review process also. You have a sign-off and a review, so you always ensure quality that somebody has performed and somebody has reviewed it in the system. And this feature is one more thing, that you can consolidate your documentation in the cloud and it stays there with the job. So whenever you want to look at in this certificate, how did we do? So you can have all the documents over here. So this feature itself is inbuilt into iFirm without any add-on. And this is a great, great thing to use for improving the quality in your services. Second is that you have a client portal, right? This is an add-on. We have subscribed to that add-on, but this add-on is very useful. The cost benefit is amazing on this. Simple reason I'll tell you, you have, say if you're a mid-sized firm, right? You have clients, sometimes during this work from home situation, what happens is that your staff can't go to their place and you need some data that you need to access over for doing the work. In this situation, generally what happens is that if you don't have a dedicated cloud-based portal or a software, you need to use some free tools, right? So here I'll just guide you with the client portal. One, it has the name of the client. So I have created a client for ourselves, Kandilal Patel and Company, for this webinar. And you have subfolders also. So within the folder, you can see that there is the name of the client and you have subfolders. Within that subfolder, this is the subfolder. Now, using client portal, you have a great advantage which looks very professional towards the client. You have your own client portal which allows clients to upload their data on your accessible network. And this information is stored in the cloud, so anybody in your organization can view this data. It is secured. You have a log that is maintained for this as to who has downloaded this data. It is accessible by you as well as the client. So that gives a great comfort to the client that the data that they are sharing, if it's a listed company, then definitely price sensitive information is being shared. So they don't like they are not comfortable using the free tools. Without iFirm, see, it's not impossible to do, but what you would do, unless you have a subscription like a OneDrive, which also to my mind is not as professional as what iFirm is, because it gives you a dedicated login, a password to the client. So if it's a free, completely free solution, you use something which is like generally people use WeShare or something like similar services. Those services, essentially, they don't have a privacy guarantee to it. You know, the clients are not comfortable using those free services. This feature assisted our firm to have seamless transfer of data between the firm and our clients. You will say that, okay, there are emails also. But see, when you have to send a larger file like a tally backup, say, for example, then how do you pass it on to the auditor without using a service? You know, it's beyond the threshold limits of attachment to an email. So this comes in very handy. It doesn't, to my mind, till now, we haven't exhausted its single file size limit on upload. It's so robust. It is so good that this has been a boon for us in handling confidential client data and with confidence. You know, it gives you a sense of confidence that you are giving clients good services. And it also acts as a point that you can make to your client that, see, we are using specific technology in the firm and this is how we are taking the advantage out of it. As chartered accountants, you know, you need to remind your clients with a lot of things. So how do we use iFirm for communication? Now, one good feature is that we send out bulk recurring email reminders. Under the bulk recurring email reminders, you always have certain reminders which are in the nature of advanced tags, maybe due date reminders, maybe data request emails, and you can automate that entire communication process in iFirm. It will send out a advanced tax reminder on the first of the month in which the advanced tax is due. You can set out reminders for GST returns, etc. So there, all those due date reminders can be automated in this, and it has a great deliverability rate. It directly lands into the inbox of the client. The advantage here is that it is completely automated and it saves a lot of time. Now our firm just has to add email address to the reminder that is set when we onboard a new client for advanced tax or other purposes. The rest of it is handled very well. Case study three, I think one of the important issues that we were facing earlier was that we had our articles, you know, in a chartered accounting firm, you always have a level of staff, which is kind of first level soldiers. Those were not very punctual in their approach towards work. So with the recent launch of this feature in iFirm, it was very useful that we can now track our resources, whether they are reaching client place on time, whether they are leaving from there on time, and it just automates the entire process. So it's a location capture, it captures the time, and it has a punch in and a punch out requirement. So it essentially solves a huge problem for us, where we used to deploy a lot of resources to monitor this. Now it is all based out of this software. So that's an advantage for us. How do we use it for timesheets? You know, the importance of timesheets in our profession, I don't have to stress on that. Everybody knows the importance and value of timesheets in our profession. How did this timesheet help us in explaining our invoices better? You know, generally, you work on an assignment, you know that you have devoted sufficient time. In the back of your mind, you're always aware that, see, this work, it's taking more time, I'll have to bill it more. Without a proper log, it becomes very difficult for you to explain your efforts to your client. Timesheets in iFirm are simplified, they are to the point, and they don't capture more information than what is required, and they don't have less time. No? So it's very neat, it's simple, and it is short and sweet, and it does the work wonderfully. Now, whenever we log hours into a job, you know, there are certain advisory and consultation jobs which you know that, okay, they are good. You have to have a higher charge out rate for consultation and advisory work rather than your annuity work. So you keep a track of the time that you have spent in the particular assignment. With that track, what you can do is, when you send out the invoice to the client, you can always add the time that you have spent on it, mentioning the activities that you have done. When you send that detailed explanation to your invoice, there are very less chances that the client will challenge the amount of the invoice. And that has been a very good helping tool for us to avoid time on negotiation or explaining our invoices. It comes very well. I'll tell you, there are a lot of tools available in the market. You know, how to choose between iFirm and the others, or maybe I haven't evaluated any other since I'm using iFirm, because since the last 4 years, we are very satisfied with the product. The only thing is that you evaluate it on how mature it is. You know, it's a mature tool to capture the relevant information. It doesn't ask you for more. It doesn't ask you for less. You get all the information that you need, and it doesn't have a cumbersome approach on things. So that's how it is useful for us. And why did our firm choose iFirm? So as I promised, I would guide you with our process, how our firm went into selecting iFirm. So see, before iFirm, we were using a co-developed software specifically developed addressing the needs of our firm. So we had partnered with a local software vendor in our city. They were keen to develop a product for the CA profession. So they were an IT company, and they partnered with us as the knowledge partner for them to develop a product which would specifically meet the requirements of a chartered accountancy firm. And we had put in a lot of effort back then. I think it's 10, 11 years back when we started developing this. And I think for maybe 10 years back, we had got it developed, and we were using it for 6-7 years. But then ultimately, you know, as the practice evolves, as the profession evolves, what happens is that you need some changes to be made in that software. Now, unless you have a mature IT firm handling this entire development process, what happens is that your software becomes laggy. It develops load on it, and it becomes slow. It becomes some issues. Then, you know, the architecture of the software is not planned in that manner where you can have the changes that you need. So based on that, we had a long evaluation before we shifted to iFirm. You know, we had been using it for 6-7 years before iFirm. So from our shift to iFirm, we have noticed one thing, that this product is, one, it's mature; two, it is reliable. So you don't have a downtime with this product. I don't recollect any downtime with this product. And definitely the product is very mature. It has a very good architecture. If you understand IT, if the backbone is very strong, it's mature, it's not fancy, it is a very mature product, as a product should be. What separates it, as I told, maturity and reliability. And second is, it's always, when you evaluate iPhone with the others, I don't know in today's time, but at least back then, this was the most expensive subscription-based product that was available on the market. And I think today also it should be, or it would be. But naturally, when you get a product of this maturity, I don't think that should be a big problem for you to spend this, and you get a lot of value for this. So obviously it's subjective. It is my own view on the pricing and stuff. Some may find it very expensive, some may find it very cheap, but I am more on the reasonability aspect. And yes, iPhone is not paying me to say any of this. So any of the viewers who are thinking that I am a paid person, no. It's my honest opinion and review about this product, and it's naturally a good way that you can manage your firm. It comes with its own hassles and hurdles of developing the mindset in your team, because any change, is not very easily accepted by the team members. You need to push it. You need to be perseverant. It means you need to persevere it, and you need to be kind of for those people who don't have the compliance mindset, then you also need to be hard and tough on them to get them in line. With this, I thank you everyone. I thank everyone for a patient hearing, and what I'll do is I'll pass it on back to the hosts, and I think they can open it up for some questions and answers.
Yeah, thank you so much, Mr. Deepak Patel, and all our participants, Mr. Cripson, Mr. Narayan. It's really been an enriching experience to hear, our customers. And of course, as Mr. Patel said, none of them are sponsored or paid for by us. It is their honest opinions that, we value, good or bad. And it only basically helps us, make our product better. So I'm looking forward to seeing any questions, etc. Leaving the floor open, thanking our panelists once again. So Neha, over to you. Any questions you'd like us to?
Yeah, Chris, we do actually have a lot of questions. So I'll start with a question which Mr. Mathur has put up. He's asking that, can we do real-time editing on uploaded documents? And is there any space or size limit on documents?
Yeah, I'll take up this question. Yeah, so there is no space limit on the storage of documents one can, store. And in the DMS module, yes, one can edit it, real time while opening the document, and it gets saved back to the portal. Yeah, any other question?
Yeah, thanks, Prasoon. I'll move on to the next question. This is, can we manage multiple billing entities for billing?
Yes, that's possible. So you want to add anything there?
If any of our speakers would like to add to this, Cripson, Mr. Narayan, Mr. Cripson, Mr. Deepam, if you're managing multiple billing entities or something sort like that, or I can take up.
Yeah, so basically, I'm sure you can manage multiple billing entities from iPhone. I think it's a configuration thing that you need to get done at the time when you onboard with iPhone, and then it's seamless to manage it across.
Okay. Yeah, thank you so much.
It's the same with us. Yeah, right now we are also managing two billing entities, and this is the good part of the iPhone, so that we can all see the integrated reports in the iPhone.
Thank you, Mr. Robson. Yeah, Deha, any other questions, please?
Yeah, thank you so much for the replies. We have something from Mr. Chirag, wherein he's asked us, is there any space limitation for client portal?
To my mind, till now nobody has complained. So I don't know, somewhere around 700-800 MB of zip file was also uploaded, but I don't know if larger than that there might be an issue, but 700-800 MB I don't think there was any issue with the soft client portal.
Yeah, you're right, Mr. Deep. We don't have any space limit for now. That's as I've already mentioned.
I'll move on to the next question. There's one wherein we've been asked if we can manage restrict rights on documents for our team.
Yes, in the DMS module, of course, we can restrict. We also have version control on that. We can also see the carbon copies of who have edited in the DMS module.
Great. And there is another, which is possible to do receivables for the invoice we raised.
If our speakers can take this question.
Yeah, I think, yes, we can do that. And this is the best part which we have felt of the form of the software till now. It's really effortless to track the receivables and the billings.
Thank you, Mr. Krupchan. Yeah, Neha, next question, please.
We have been asked, what is the cost?
So I think we can talk about that, but our cost is basically linked to the number of users in your firm. So the more the users, of course, slightly lower per user cost, but that's something we can come back to you with a specific proposal. Please drop us your email and contact number and we can come back to you with the pricing. It is a SaaS based model, so it's a per user per month kind of pricing that we have.
We also have a question or two on, is there a free demo of the product? I would like to say that yes, there is. You can please write to us on info@voltagekluwerindia.co.in and we'll get back in touch with you. And we're inviting the last few questions. If somebody has something to ask, you may please put it up on the Q&A panel, or you can also raise your hand and we'll address them. We have one.
Mr. Srivastav has raised on MIS reporting. Can it be extracted in Excel, and do we have MIS reporting functionality as well? So Mr. Srivastav, answer to that is yes, all the reports can be extracted in Excel. You can do your own analysis if you want, extracting from the system. And we have a robust reporting system which comprises more than 80 world-class inbuilt reports segregated into different segments that a CA firm or a tax and accounting firm requires to get their MIS job done. The reports are divided into employees, into jobs, into cash flows. So there are different segments which the report has been divided for your ease to cater your reporting requirement. Yes, Neha.
Thank you so much, Prasoon. I think with that, we've come to a close with regards to all the questions that we have. Chris, I think we can call it a close.
Thank you all. Thank you all for your participation, and hope everyone stays safe. Please wear masks, use sanitizers. I don't want to talk more about that, but yeah, thank you again to all our panelists, Mr. Patel, Mr. Narayan, Mr. Krupchan, for taking the time out and sharing their valuable insights. We really appreciate it. And to all the participants, look forward to hearing from you. We're happy to set up any demos or provide any other information that you need. Thanks again for making this webinar a good success. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Chris. Thank you so thank much. You all. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Take care.
It was a pleasure.
Thank you, everybody. And we'll be sharing a link of the recording very soon. Thank you so much for attending. Bye-bye.
Thank you.